special thing about the new artificial agents that we are creating is that they indeed are agents. Technologies start to act, as it were, not like humans act. They are not humans, obviously, but they're also not just mute and silent tools. And that action expresses itself in the fact that they are learning. So they can behave in a way that was never told to them by their designers. In interaction with their environment, they develop a behavior that was unpredictable and that we have to learn to deal with as humans. They can be very helpful in human life. For instance, robots in healthcare can help to perform tasks that are hard to do for humans, or it can sometimes even be less embarrassing for a patient to be helped by a robot than by a human. So specific values can be served quite well with the help of robots. On the other hand, we also need to be able to interact as humans in a good way with the robots. And that means that we also sometimes need to be able to distinguish what a robot is and what a human is. And especially when they grow together, this can become a challenge. In education, for instance, the role of the teacher can be really the role of a role model, right? So if an algorithm or a robot gets involved in teaching, we should be really careful not to lose that important dimension in teaching when we start to do things like that.
Technology is shaping the way we are and the way we develop. Actually, I was very concerned about this because we are losing some abilities like orienting in a city, having GPS or orthography or calculation. Nowadays in internet, there are many AI agents that put content. Content in the sense of news, opinions, all sorts of conversations and posts. And it is important to learn to distinguish what is real and what is fake. For, in particular, young people, it is not easy to make this distinction. It requires critical awareness. I mean, being critical about everything you see, you read, doubting, investigating more. So I am very much in favor of developing critical awareness in young people, in schools, universities, and through all the learning process.
The ethics of artificial intelligence should not only focus on how AI systems work on humans, but also on how humans interact with these AI systems. And that's a totally different field. What does it mean to interact with a robot? What does it tell about ourselves if we try to understand how we interact with a robot?
We're interested in the human side of human-robot communication because there's so much research and development that's invested in what's going on from the technology side, how do robots respond, how do robots look, etc. But we know so little about the human mind, the human brain, and what's going on within our heads when we interface with technology. So there's lots of really rich and unique cultural differences. One really nice example of this is that we know that people who've grown up, for example, in big cities in Japan, such as Tokyo, they live in a robotics-rich culture, and they are much happier in some ways and much more ready to accept robots in all sorts of social contexts compared to, for example, people in Western Europe who maybe have not seen robots in everyday life as much. They might just know them from films and from television, so they might be a little bit more reluctant to accept help from a robot or education from a robot. So understanding how cultural backgrounds and cultural contexts shape our willingness to engage with robots and what we might get out of interactions with them will be really vital into the future.
The rise of robots and artificial agents in our society raises a lot of ethical questions, concerns even. And these are typically about the values that are important in our society that might be affected when robots start to interact with us. Which values are they, and how can we design them into the machines, as it were? Or how can we keep them upright when we use or implement a robot in a specific practice?
It is the relationships that we are constructing that in turn shape us. This was said by Robert Solomon, a philosopher, who said it in relation to people, like teachers, our parents, our friends, shape the way we are. So if we interact so much with machines, we have to know that these machines are going to shape us. So we better think twice what technology we are developing.